My name is Christopher Edwards. I'm the development lead for the visible and infrared observation system on NASA's ESCAPADE mission to Mars. ESCAPADE is a NASA mission to help understand Mars. On that mission, NAU contributed a couple of cameras to help view the surface of Mars while ESCAPADE's orbiting. Sending cameras to another planet, especially places like Mars, is pretty uncommon. And so we engaged a bunch of students as part of 3-semester-long courses, and we had the opportunity to build a new technology in a cheap and more affordable way and send those cameras to Mars on the ESCAPADE mission.
T-minus 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Lift off detected.
Sense motion.
Everyone has cleared the tower.
Watching spacecraft and a rocket launch with the spacecraft on it is a strangely emotional experience. There's a lot of excitement mixed with anxiety, mixed with happiness, and it's like this total emotional roller coaster because you have this thing that you've built, that you've held in your hands, that you've spent, you know, ostensibly years of your life working on, has this big kind of pivotal moment where you end up in a situation where you have no control of what happens next. There is an extremely risky event that happens for, you know, 7 to 40 minutes long, right? However long the launch takes. So it's all these different steps. And then, you know, we're waiting, you know, even right now for the final signal of ESCAPADE to come through. There are all kinds of different things that have to happen autonomously for everything to go right. It's a very strange field that we work in to have all of our hard work depend on so many of these moments that have to go just perfectly right for you to get to Mars. It is currently in this Earth loitering orbit where it will hang out until next fall. It'll do a couple flybys of the Earth and the Moon, and then it'll use that, basically Earth's gravity, to slingshot itself to Mars. Once ESCAPADE gets to Mars, the spacecraft orient themselves once per orbit, and an orbit is like 6 to 8 hours long. We can take pictures over the polar caps, and that's pretty great because that's a place where there's a lot of dynamics happening, and we can use the temperature of the polar cap combined with the reflectivity or visible images to basically help us identify clouds or storms or the buildup of CO2 ice. And there's really a whole bunch of different things that we can do to try to understand what the dynamics and really the energy balance is of Mars.